May the sun grant you a portion of its wisdom, young huntress.
What brings you Karja so far from your home?
There's good machine hunting in the cut. Danger, too. Some have a taste for both, and they pay people like me well to guide them. We've had a bad run this time, even after I brought this priest along to read the signs.
I did say the sun's light was cast quite red the night of the...
Not your concern, though, Huntress. May your arrows find their mark. You're a long way from home, too. Watch your back out there.
I suppose it's time to go back to work. I think I'll take a little more over when I was in charge.
Prince Edelman is alive and in the palace. Praise the sun. May the sun light your way. Only a matter of time before an offering was shot into the town. The tonic? Still functioning. If I could bring that tonic back from the dead, they'd get noticed. Encased in ice. It fell a long time ago. The scavengers have just gotten started. Protecting it. This tall neck was probably holy to them. should scan the Talmec. See how deep the damage goes. Lucky me. Looks like the scavengers ripped out three major parts. If I could bring them back, maybe I could even reactivate it. Get it with inside its head.
Thank you.
tall next part. It's heavy. Intact. Till next are real tough. Bring that tall neck back from the dead. They get noticed. The Veneuve were protecting it. This tall neck was probably holy to them. Very cold. I get it. This tonic part's still in one piece. Ouch. Thank you. Okay, they're heading back. It's in better shape than it was. Okay, I'm right. Just need to get the power flowing through again. And if I'm wrong, at least no one's watching. Wake you up? Easy now. Easy! Right, it's never easy. Just have to reach its head. Breaking out the tall neck ought to get the Werax's attention once war gets around. Let's find this blue game a better home. Deal with that tower. Thank you. some sort of scanning device. They've seen me. Bandits aren't subtle. Clearing them out would send a different kind of message. Strung up machine parts. An alarm signal.
Not sure what that was. You're not afraid of little old me, are you? I'm too blasted jumpy.
I'd have to ditch something. What's that?
Smells peaceful. I hate peace. A lot of people die peacefully. Not me. I got a feeling. Search the camp. Get out there, turn over every rock, see what comes crawling out.
Could any of you find a charcoal pile in a flat field? I don't think so.
Can't scare me. Come out.
Get out there, turn over every rock, see what comes crawling out.
Someone trying to get my attention? Got someone over here. Doesn't look good.
Could any of you find a charcoal pile in a flat field? I don't think so.
Come on, Daisy. Don't be afraid. I'll only kill you once. Guess it was in my knot.
Off your bums and start. Don't give up.
Yasram's fire weapon. Could come in handy. won't be long before the Werak finds out I took out the bandit camp. In fact, I'll bet my name's all over Song's Edge.
Caution.
Might be time to challenge Aratak.
Raids only get us stronger. So it is with every trial the Banu can endure.
Yeah.
makes the great Werax of Banur better than ours. We hunt just as well.
No one hunts like the Banuk, but I've heard the Nora can handle their bows.
We can hunt.
Help me out, Nora, would you?
Trust the shamans.
What can I do for you, Bergrund?
Mourn my poor departed luck. I finally met some Banuk, keen to trade with outlanders. Then, they up and vanished. Three Banuk hunters rolled in a few days ago. No provisions, junk equipment, no idea how to strip a machine for parts. Asked me to outfit them for a long trip. And you know me, Aloy. I'm sentimental. So, I did it on credit.
And they haven't paid.
Well, they tried. Just look what they did to this Thunderjaw heart. But that was ages ago. And I'm starting to worry about them.
Tell me, Bergrund, are you worried about their well-being or your purse strings?
A man can worry about two things.
Uh-huh. What kind of deal was this, really?
Just what I said. I was nothing but generous, Aloy. After they dropped this ruined heart at my feet, I even gave them another chance. Sent them to fetch a few other parts I need.
But you haven't seen them since.
Hide nor hair.
What do you mean they couldn't harvest parts?
Not uncommon with Banuk. That's shaman's work, you see. The hunters take down the machines. The shamans slice them up. No shaman with these three. Just two youngsters sniping at each other. And that big fella, standing there smiling.
So if the Banuk don't usually hunt without a shaman, what's the story with these three?
They weren't telling, but hammer to steel. It's not a happy story, whatever it is.
You said they asked you to outfit them for a trip. A trip to where?
Not sure, but I heard them chattering about the Sundom when they thought I wasn't listening.
So they're leaving Banuk territory.
Sensible behavior. Still, I get the sense this wasn't a sightseeing trip. They're running from something.
I'm not a debt collector, Bergrund. If I look for them, it'll be to make sure they're all right.
Of course, of course! Fires of the Forge, forgive me. I actually like these idiots. The molten steel of youth and all that. But, if you do manage to find them, you could remind them of the deal we made. A scorcher claw, a loop of sinew from a stalker, and a snap maw fang. If they bring me those parts, their debt's paid. And then some. Just make sure they don't bust them up too badly.
I'll consider it.
Last I saw them, they were heading northeast. Good machine hunting up that way. If you decide they're worth the trouble, you might look for them there.
It's odd to see new machines in the cut, but we mustn't let them frighten us.
When the old ones were fresh in their graves and our numbers were still small, it was sheep. Something of a rarity these days.
Kurin Fukuli spent her time fishing or scrubbing dyes or hunting. What purpose do her paintings serve?
Not afraid of heights, are you, Sakuli?
What's to fear? A drop from this height, I'd just make one more painting.
Araya said you two were friends.
I paint about what I feel now, not the way things used to be. Araya understood. Most Banuk didn't. I would have been exiled if she hadn't had Aratak take me into their Werak.
I'll leave you to it. I get the feeling you prefer to work alone.
It's my curse.
If we truly made camp at Stone Mead, I'm careful.
And carry the light inside. Well, Sophie marched toward home, and the machines marched behind her.
Hope you're holding up all right.
My people have been telling tales of your accomplishments. Seems you have taken a special interest in our stretch of snow out there.
Yes. And apparently, this is the only way I'll get to see all of it.
Is this a challenge?
For the Werak.
You? This must be a joke!
It is not a joke, Aratak!
Now I see. The Outlander's your pawn. And with you backing her claim, I have no choice but to accept. I expected better of you, sister.
It was you who forbid me from Thunder's drum, brother.
Brother and sister? This is a little more complicated than I thought.
No, it's simple. You will meet me at the Frost Figures, and I'll put a quick end to this mockery.
I suppose I owe you an explanation.
Yeah. I suppose you do. So why didn't you tell me that you and Aratak are siblings?
I thought I wouldn't have to. I'm surprised Aratak brought it up in front of a stranger. He must be very angry. Not always the best judge of
people.
I prefer the company of spirits. They're simply my own. I didn't want you to think of our pilgrimage as some sort of family squabble. It's much more important than that.
It's bold, I'll give you that. Going after your own brother.
He gave me no choice. He thinks I'm a child to be shoved to the back of the hunt. He would forbid me from my destiny. And yet, Part of me did it knowing he would forgive me, eventually. He always does.
Family drama aside, what's this challenge meant to be anyway?
You and Aratak will hunt machines at the Frost Figures. The victor will be the fastest. It won't be easy.
Nothing about this has been so far.
When you meet us at the starting point, I'll tell you more. It will be simpler to explain from the base of the hills.
Araya, it's not about who's related to who. I want to know what's inside Thunder's drum. The spirit, the daemon, and how it all connects to the machines. But if we're gonna go through with this, I need you to be straight with me.
I underestimated you. And Aratak. I won't make that mistake again.
See you at the Frost Figures, then. So, off to risk my life in order to take charge of a Banuk hunting band. Just what I always wanted. Frost Figures, here I come.
Run into each other again. If I didn't know any better, I'd think you were following me.
Just up there. The Frost Figures. Our attack on Araya must be close.
Outlander. I have prevailed over such challenges before, and fear none. But This one is foolish. You are not Banuk. You do not understand my responsibilities. I ask you, one hunter to another, withdraw.
Will you let us go to Thunderstrom?
You haven't seen what's up there, Outlander. I will not risk my sister's life again.
Then we better get on with this.
So be it! I will bury your insolent claim in the frozen ground!
Enough! Let us begin! To hunt! To strive! That is the way of the Banuk and of the contest before you. You will climb the frost figures from the east, Aratok from the west. Each trail wends its way through deadly machines. Hunters from the Werak will be posted along the way. They will hail you, calling out machines for you to slay. Your hunt will take you around the ridge to the center, where you must descend to the valley for your final kill. Each time, after your prey has fallen, you must launch a beacon such as this, so that all our kin will see your progress.
Kill machines, launch balloons. Got it. So, the first of us to launch the third balloon wins?
Well, yes. But as Challenger, your path to victory is harder. If even one of your beacons comes in after Aratox, he prevails.
You had your chance, Outlander.
So did you.
The hunt begins on my mark. Now!
All right, gotta head up that mountain. Looks like there are a few ways to go up, and those rock paintings mark the path. Okay, up we go. Wasting. Almost to the top.
All right, Challenger. We need to take out the herd below. Every machine.
Kill a herd. Okay, I can do that.
Ah!
your marker!
All right, here we go.
Come on, climb up here! Now climb the ridge and launch your balloon!
Haratok knows what he's doing. No time to waste.
Take the rappel point to the next challenge.
Two bellowbacks ahead, Challenger. Kill them both. None of the other machines matter.
All right, two dead bellowbacks coming up.
Now take the zipline and work your way down to the valley.
Storm's kicking up. Can't see much. Close now. Almost down. All right, to the last challenge.
Something's wrong. My kin should be here, driving in our final quarry.
They're right behind us!
it's true. Frostclaws from Thunder's Drum.
The attack cut short the competition. Naturally, there can be no result. It is void.
You saw what she did. She defeated the machines, not I. It is proven. She is the better hunter. We are Banuk. Survive, prevail. What else matters? My blood is in your teeth. I take my place behind you on the hunt.
No more hunters may make the ascent to Thunder's Drum. The way is closed to all but the chieftain and myself.
It is not my place, but I would ask a boon. To accompany you and my sister.
It might be permitted. But only if you do as I say.
No. Only if you do as I say.
Thunder's Drum awaits. There's a camp at its base, Longnotch it's called. Meet us there when you're ready. Chieftain.
A new outfit. And a weapon like Aratok's. I guess the chieftain gets the chieftain's gear. And now it's a long notch. Nothing left to keep me from Thunder's Drum.
Thank you.
Nutritious.
Kills.
Nobody. That's who.
I'm a friend. Bergren sent me, told me you might need some help.
That Osteron blowhard in Song's Edge? Did he pretend to be concerned for us?
We're doing fine. We don't need to be looked after like children.
That's not the way Bergren tells it. He says you tried to settle up with him using a shattered Thunderjaw heart.
What? That's an exaggeration. It was only broken in two.
Urkai, we don't have time for this. Come on, boys, back to the hunt. We still need two more of Bergren's components.
What's the rush?
We want out of these lands as soon as possible. That's all you need to know.
Why are you leaving the Cut?
Well, we could go back to Bon-Or. Let Unedited slit our throats.
By the blue light, Urkai. Why don't you just write our story in the snow for any passing hunter to read? We had a dispute with the chieftain of our old Werak. We thought someone else should have been in charge. He disagreed.
It seemed like a good time to move on. So, we're traveling to the Sundom.
From here to the Sundom? It's a long trip.
Seems worth it. Sometimes survival is about knowing when to leave and where to go.
Yeah, and in this case, survival means us getting as far away as we can from Bon-Or. We've seen enough red snow.
What's the plan once you get there? What will survival be about then?
Look, all that matters is that we get there. And to do that, we need shards. So if you'll excuse us.
So this Thunderjaw heart you brought Bergren...
Let me ask you this, all right? Why would it matter that the heart was broken into two pieces? Can't you just stick it back together?
Of course you can't just stick it back together!
I just meant...
Oh, I bet that scam artist Osterim could! He just wants to send us on another stupid errand!
Oh, he's not so bad. I like Bergren.
Like him? Tulamot, he sent us out in the snow to nearly die under the feet of a Thunderjaw, and—
Boys, shut up! Ugh! Every time someone brings up that stupid heart.
I've got the Scorcher Claw Bergren was asking for. That only leaves the Stalker Sinew and the Snap Maw Fang.
You should hold on to it. You're coming along to the next hunt after all, aren't you?
I suppose somebody's got to keep you three out of trouble.
Fine. I guess you'll have to tag along, then. But don't start thinking you're one of us. The Bloody Snowdrifts aren't accepting new hunters.
Bloody Snowdrifts? That's what you want to call our Werak?
Yeah, it's not great to die.
Well, it's not like your names are any better. You. We're headed northwest, to the ruins near Hollow Hall. We'll be waiting. Okay, so you're not terrible in a fight. Are you still here?
Thanks for your help, Huntress.
We told you we'd meet you at the next hunt, didn't we? Okay, so you're not terrible in a fight.
We destroyed this pack!
Scrabbling a bit. There's the herd. Everyone ready?
Are you joking? We were born ready. Let's go get them, Flaming Skulls!
Nope. That's awful.
It is a pretty bad name. Good effort though, Urkai.
Forget it. Let's just go kill something.
Thank you. I sharpened my spear today! Here goes!
Get some energy to prepare.
Gonna run right over this one.
I don't know about you three, but I feel better. Aloy, did you get that component?
Oh, got it.
That's another part down. One more and you'll have what you need to pay off Bergrund.
Starting to feel real, you know. I'm starting to believe we're really gonna get out of here. Honestly, I wasn't sure we'd survive a week without Nekoni. But here we are.
Who's Nekoni?
She was a friend of ours. She challenged the chieftain for control of the Werak.
She didn't make it.
No. If you're gonna tell this story, tell it true.
She was murdered.
Is this why you left Ben-Hur? Because of this business with Nekoni and your chieftain?
Onakut knew Nekoni was our mentor, our friend. We couldn't stay.
That final night, we snuck back to camp, packed what we could, and left.
Like cowards.
What are we to Tai? We are Banuk, aren't we? Survive and prevail. That's what we do.
It's not what she did.
Nekoni challenged the chieftain. Why?
Onakut wrapped himself in power and authority the way some people wrap themselves in furs. If you're willing to fawn over him and sing false songs to him, you might get a spot on the best hunts. The Werak split into two. Those willing to lick the bottoms of Onakut's feet, and the rest of us, waiting for things to get better.
Until Nekoni.
She was the best and bravest of us. She was the one who took a stand.
What happened? How did you lose Nekoni?
She challenged the chieftain to a hunting competition. Onakut, damn him! He wasn't nearly the hunter Nekoni was. But who comes back to the camp after the trial? Onakut, grinning like a snap maw, crowing, "Oh, where's little Nekoni?"
We tracked Nekoni through the woods. Found her not far from the trailhead.
Their damn neck snapped.
I don't want to remember her like that. Sometimes that memory, it's all I can think of. I'm sorry, Tai. It sounds like she meant a lot to you. To all of you. I'm sorry for what you've been through.
It's nice to be heard. Thank you, Emily.
Look. It doesn't matter, okay? What happened in Ben-Hur is buried in Ben-Hur. What matters now is what happens in the Sundom. That's where the burning turkeys are gonna make a name for ourselves, right?
Oh, the burning turkeys? Seriously?
It rolls off the tongue.
Sort of like vomit?
So, where to next?
There's a lake just west of here. Seems like a good place to find a snapmall fang. We'll meet you there.
If you beat us there, just wait by the campfire. We'll be along.
Montana Recreations.
Beautiful. How fierce you must have been. That fur. You never even felt the cold, did you? If he hadn't preserved you, would anyone even know you could have treated...
Visitor centers a bust. I'm recording the strategic and operational value at roughly 0 point squat. No reason we shouldn't pack the staff onto a herd and send them back to nowhere as well as soon as the gates are locked. Enjoy basic income, ding-dongs.
I hate to interrupt.
Oh, I... Yes. Hello, I... Well, an outlander at the Shrine of Forgotten Beasts. Welcome. I'm Enjuk.
Aloy. The Shrine of... what?
When the old world still breathed, a great man built a tiny totem to this beast and stored the visage inside. When the totem was placed on the pedestal, the animal is... painted onto the empty air. And the beast lives again. Well, almost.
There are 7 pedestals. Where are the other 6 figurines?
I found this one in the wilds. Remembered the indentations in the pedestals here and saw how they matched the base of the totem. But as you say, it's 1 of 7, isn't it? The great Montana recreations must have made more, but time has scattered them.
So these totems, the images they show are of animals that no longer exist. They're gone, like the old ones.
So it seems. To think such magnificent creatures are lost to us that we never even knew they were here. We rely as much on beasts as we do on machines. For food, for warmth, but do we study them with the same fervor? Yeah, I do, for example. I have this theory about foxes. Why do foxes have red fur? Think about what they eat.
Meat?
Raw meat. Bloody meat. See? Natural causation. Logical connections. It only makes sense.
You've thought a lot more about foxes than I have. You said a great man made these figurines?
Indeed. He was, I believe, a student of the natural world. Like me. But surpassing my abilities 1,000 times over. The great Montana recreations. Perhaps the finest natural scholar the old world ever produced. His voice claims responsibility for the totems, the vessels for the knowledge he accumulated. I share his desire to understand the beasts, to catalog their behaviors and preserve their images. I like to flatter myself that I'm an apprentice of sorts, carrying on his work. Someday, perhaps, if I am persistent, I can earn his name. Enjuk Recreations.
What do you think of these, Enjuk?
Thank you.
Thank you, Aloy. Look, such form and poise they have upon their pedestals. Montana Recreations truly captured their legacy.
I should get going.
Of course, of course. I've taken up so much of your time already.
But I don't suppose you could keep an eye out for more figurines?
If I run across any, I'll bring them your way.
Canis Lupus, the enigmatic gray wolf. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Could it be that these wolves and our foxes are the same somehow? Perhaps after hundreds of winters...
No. No, that's ridiculous.
Odocolius virginianus, the majestic mule deer. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Not built like a predator, but perhaps it needed those horns to take down its prey in the absence of sharp fangs.
Ursus Arctos, the menacing grizzly bear. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Those claws look like they could rip someone in half.
Perhaps in its youth, but you heard Montana Recreations. He said it's grizzled, old. Its hunting days are behind it.
Puma Concolor, the fearsome cougar. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
Its coat is sand-colored. Could it have been a burrowing animal? Perhaps those teeth were only used for digging.
Ursus Americanus, the magnificent American black bear. Brought to you by Montana Recreations.
How would you like to find yourself cornered by that thing?
I suspect I'd like it very much indeed. What a beautiful beast you were!
This is as high as we go. Okay. Grapes. I was starting to worry about you three. Everything all right?
We took our time. After our last conversation, we had a lot to think about.
I can imagine. Just one more hunt, then your debt is paid and you three can make your way south. Ready?
Huntress, the Sunshine Snowshoes await your signal.
Horrible!
I'm almost impressed, Dulamok. Didn't think you could come up with a name worse than Burning Turkeys.
Well, I liked it. Let's hunt.
All right. Let's go get this Osral off our backs.
Thank you.
got some for you.
Stay down. That'll keep my stomach quiet. That wasn't a warning.
Come here, Aloy. Let's have a proper goodbye.
Takes care of that.
There. That's the last of Bergren's parts. Looks like you three are out of debt. For now.
Until Orkai breaks something else.
It was one time!
You make a nice shaman, Aloy. Thanks for lending a hand. Maybe we'll meet you in the Sundom sometime.
Once you get to the Sundom, what then? What's the next step?
We hunt like Nekoni wanted to hunt.
Nekoni had big dreams. A werak in which everyone pulls their weight and takes care of each other. No shamans, no chieftains, no need to pry the power out of anybody's hands.
Sounds like a lot of work.
But worth it, I think. And a fitting tribute to Nekoni. We can become the werak she always wished for.
You won't have me to strip your kills now. Are you three gonna be all right?
Doesn't look that hard, really. We'll be fine.
Great. He washes three successful harvests and he's suddenly a shaman.
When you get to Song's Edge, talk to Bergrind. If he can't teach you himself, he'll know someone who can.
Sure. And I bet he charges us for the introduction.
Thank you, Aloy. I'm sure we'll figure it out.
I guess this is goodbye. How does it feel, putting Banuk lands behind you?
The only thing I would have missed is already gone.
Let all those rotten Bonor suck-ups freeze to death.
It's a little much, Urkai, don't you think? That's strange. What is it to be Banuk after Banur forsakes you? How do we decide who we are? How about you, Aloy? Who do you think we are? What will you remember of us?
You lost someone you care about. That leaves a wound. This sort of wound a lot of people don't recover from.
Yeah. We've got nothing but scars to show for it.
That's the point. Only survivor scar. After everything you've been through, you keep going.
We're the Scars of the North.
Scars of the North. Sounds pretty tough, doesn't it?
Thank you, Aloy. It's a good name. One we'll honor. I'm very thankful we met you, Aloy.
You're all right, Aloy. Thanks.
I kinda got used to hunting with you, Aloy.
Strange one, that Sikuli. But no one can deny her skill.
In the old days, the magic.
Inatut. As we are bound by laws, you are bound by wire. Yet your crime was the act of killing. So we must drive you out. Away from the Werek. From protection. From our songs.
My chieftain. Kopalot. Am I not your favorite fighter? Do you not recognize me from this tooth you knocked out?
How many times have I pulled you from danger by your neck? Made excuses for your behavior? You are my favorite. But the shaman is decided. While you wait for exile, think on what brought you here.
A test of strength? Who among us would refuse a challenge from an outlander? Not I! But I did not kill him!
Hush, hush. You can tell your story to the ice.
You took Artok's mantle.
It's mine now.
I would have liked to see that fight.
They said that you killed someone.
Perhaps I did. Even my chieftain accepts that it must be so.
That's not the way it works for me. Want to tell me your story?
I did fight with a Karja hunter to settle a challenge. That much is true. He was strong and damn quick. We traded punches. Good punches. Hard punches. And the next thing I remember... gray morning light, and the Karja beside me, with his head broken open. But the blow was not by my hand.
Isn't your Werek supposed to support you? At least give you the benefit of the doubt?
When our Werek had cause to quarrel, I was a solution. To fight for its honor and win, they'd call on me. Or, when they needed someone to lose, for appearances, I could do that too. Now an outlander is murdered without honor, all eyes are on me. I have become my Werek shame.
They don't want an incident with the Karja, so you take the fall.
That's what I do best.
So everyone knows you started the fight with this man.
Of course. For honor, I'll fight anyone. If I wasn't bound, I'd fight to prove myself right now.
I don't think that would help you.
This is what I am. Each runner in the Werek has a gift. I brawl. None can take a punch, a fall better than I can. Until this time, I was too drunk. We were grappling. He clapped my ears. I took one last swing as I went down, but not a killing blow. It can't have been.
And for your punishment, they'll exile you from the Werek?
From warmth. March me up the slopes of the cloud shear, leave me stripped and exposed.
That's awful.
If I survive, the land has absolved me. That's the law. It must be accepted.
It's still awful.
I'm not stupid. I don't like my chances either. I can't fight a mountain.
I'll be honest. You haven't got a good defense, Inatut.
I've heard that one before.
Where did the fight happen?
A clearing, just outside the Karja Outlanders camp. You should talk to them. They wouldn't hear me out. They say no one else could have been there, other than me and the dead man. The shaman consulted the signs in the snow and agreed.
I'll see what I can find out. And I'll be back.
I'll be here. What else am I gonna do? Until the horn gives a call for my exile.
Back again, Huntress? Traitors.
I was asked to look into the murder of a Karja hunter. What happened?
It's plain as day. A drunk Banuk thug picked a fight with Ruas, struck him down from behind and stole his headdress.
The accused man says that he didn't do it.
You're not going to get anything useful out of the Banuk, whether they talk to you or don't. They gather up like cloaks in a chill wind every time a hunter dies out here. Won't even hand Ruas's killer over for a proper trial.
A proper trial?
To fill his mouth with salt, and hold him up for the sun to consider over days. If it is Clement, it may only take his sight, or his wits.
So other Karja hunters have died in these lands before?
3, maybe 4 in the last few seasons. That's no surprise. This place punishes even the prepared, and many young nobles don't prepare. But usually the snow covers everything, and the bodies are never found. No thanks to the Banuk.
Do you think they're involved?
No. If it's not about their tribe, they don't want to get involved.
In these outlands, even the sun cannot thaw all it touches.
Doesn't sound like you trust the Banuk much.
They're not without their reasons to keep apart from us. 10 years of reasons.
Always the war. The war is over. We made amends, but no. The land never forgets.
Snow and ice keep memory, they say.
It takes time for scars to heal.
You think I don't know that? I still bear the lashes for refusing one of the Mad King's sun priests. I was your age then.
Times of shadow. Times of shadow.
Where did you find Ruas's body?
There's no hunt, girl. Nothing to pick up.
Humor me. I'm a good tracker.
Down the rise to the west, there's a clearing. But a grazer herd couldn't have trampled it better. And if that barbarian gives up Ruas's headdress before they cast him out, let me know. It's valuable.
Now that Prince Edomin has returned to Meridian, is the war well and truly over?
I'm more tired than usual. Should have eaten more at breakfast.
Those cowards at Sunfall tried to use the prince as a bargaining chip. But you put a stop to that.
I bet those traitorous Oseram will just conveniently lose Derval and transport to Mainspring.
Prince Edomin is alive and well in Meridian. The Karja in Shadow have been... proven baseless traitors.
That's a load off.
Been disturbed a lot, like the Huntress said. Blood on the snow. This is where Ruas fell. It does seem that only 2 people fought here. Not looking good for Inatut. That was used for the killing blow. Didn't try to hide the weapon. Question is Inatut the kind of fighter who hits from behind with a tree branch? Now here's something. Lots of leaves and bark scraped off here. When someone pulled out the branch? No. From climbing it. They came through the trees. Thank you. good view of the Karja camp and the clearing. This is ominous. A dead end? Can't be. Someone covered this over. What are they trying to hide? Armor. This looks bad.
It has a map. The deed is done. Another card.
Someone's here!
Not Banook.
Then she won't be missed.
We've got company. You've been killing Karja. And for what? Revenge for the war?
Who gets to declare that one tribe no longer hates another? I'll tell you, not the ones who fought. Not the ones whose songs are silenced. Like my kin.
For what you did, another Banook has been sentenced to certain death. What about his song?
Oh, that's why you followed us. For that punch-drunk idiot in it. Fate is sharp today. They've already let him out to face his exile. Let's see who the cold claims first.
I need to go after Inatut. But I should find some more evidence first. Trophies. Newer than the rest. Must have belonged to Ruas. So it was a Karja soldier's. Not that it's any excuse. Did they keep any clothes? This Karja gear's not warm. But if Inatut's naked on a snowfield, he'll take what he gets. Okay, time to get moving. You'd take someone if you wanted to lose them forever. I'm not getting up that frozen waterfall. Maybe along the sides. Halfway there. Solid. Mixed feelings about that. Inatut? Inatut! Maybe you found shelter? I hope you found shelter. Behind the rock.
Thank you.
Aura Girl? Is it really you, or has the bone chill got through my skull?
I found the real killers. No one else has to die because of this. Take these.
A dead Karsha's clothes. Haven't I been beaten down enough? But I won't argue. Where thought I'd saw my ancestors. They said we'd surprise you ended up here.
Better hurry. Machines.
Thank you.
feel my... I can't feel much of anything in this.
That was a fight.
Your trial's over. It was other Banuk who killed that man. Killed him because he was Karja.
You know why I took the first swing at him? He challenged the honor of the Banuk. The honor. That's what I thought.
Come on. Let's get you back.
Once I'm off the mountain, I'll find my own way. I need to think. It's not something I'm used to. Who knows what could happen?
I'll see you at town, then. You'd better make it, all right?
I give my pledge.
So by the new law, if Inatut survives, he's forgiven. But I want to prove to his chieftain that he wasn't guilty in the first place. Hello there. My mount can't find its footing on these slopes.
She'll be back. She never falters.
But if she has, then I'm the one who can throw a spear the farthest.
And I'm the one who can climb ice the fastest.
You have passed one test. The next test is of silence. A Werek chieftain from the Nora. Strange omens. What do you make of it, Shaman?
My thoughts on this are clouded. I must take in the smoke of burnt wires to clear them.
We are of the White Teeth, come down from the jawbone of Banur to test those who would run with us.
A test? In those hunting grounds?
No, it is an ordeal. Survive upon the glacier and the knife trail, as our ancestors did. It's been a harsh season. Two have yet to return. We shall wait. Then we shall bless their attempt. Then we shall leave.
What does this ordeal involve?
To scale the glacier's face and endure 4 days and four nights, sustained only from the frozen ground and the machines. Our shaman has blessed the ordeal and permitted their harvest.
Metal to fashion weapons. The rest is forbidden.
What about the two who haven't returned?
It was their ordeal to face alone, their life or death. Those who return know the White Teeth run alongside them. Those who do not know the White Teeth mark their attempt.
How generous. So who are the White Teeth?
Warriors. The first and the best. All young hunters hungry for the fight seek to run with us. Now the machines are angered. There was always fighting. We are well served, eh, Shaman?
Every day, lightning cracks in the smoke of battle. Every night, a new name to honor in song.
Aren't you even going to look for your missing hunters?
In time. As months pass, the meltwater often carries the bodies out.
Unbelievable. If there's a chance they're alive, then I'll look for them.
Even if they did still live, they will not accept your aid, Outlander. To us, survival is sacred.
Nothing else can be relied upon.
We'll see. Survival is sacred. So they leave people to die?
Nah, you blow back at us like a headwind.
With questions.
My ears chafe already.
All right, I'm going.
And we shall remain.
think I found one of the hunters.
Outlander, huh? Well, who else would join me on this path I've taken?
Which path would that be?
Away from tradition. Away from the Werak. It's not so. Damn. Maybe metal too. But my need is greater.
The Banuk don't accept help. Is it true?
They don't. I do. An outlander. Chieftain of a Werak. It's stranger in the cut than I thought.
You're telling me.
You fight well. I am a Kree.
Thank you. I'm Aloy. I heard the White Teeth were missing two hunters. You look like you could leave if you wanted to, so...
I stayed because of the other. My Len. She snapped her leg descending the ice. I bided my time keeping vigil, but now she must return to the Werak before they leave.
Is joining the White Teeth so important to you?
It's one of the great Weraks of Ban-Ur. Not so many great ones left now. I would go where my Lin went. I was her shadow on the snow, and she was mine. To be a runner with the White Teeth was everything to her.
What's this ordeal supposed to prove?
That we have the strength of our ancestors. That we can survive as they did. When they came in search of a homeland, some were trapped against this glacier by a snowstorm. 4 days, 4 nights. After the storm cleared, the survivors sighted a tall neck, which led them up into Banor. Well, that's the story I learned anyway.
You know this Mylan well.
Since our knees were always skinned. All my life. In a test to prove that we only need ourselves. That was my weakness.
Sounds like she was lucky for your weakness.
That's not the way she sees it.
Mylan won't let you help her, will she? Because of the rules of this test.
You're quick as a rockfall.
No, just used to being told what's forbidden to me.
She won't allow it. Won't take the medicinal plants I found or the food. Only what she can scrape up on hands and knees. I could get close when she was delirious. But now she's learned not to let me get close.
So let's get her back to the Werrick.
All right. I've made a splint for her leg. Medicine for the pain, but I should warn you, she won't take them willingly. The law of survival...
Tribal law shouldn't keep us apart from the ones we care for.
Even if she cares more for the law.
Too much already.
That's where we're going. The frozen flow from the ice boulder. It keeps many things, but it won't have her.
Not if we can help it.
More up?
We're lucky. Handholds have thawed. There. She's passed out again.
Between us, we can fight the machines off before they reach her.
Another tradition broken.
Take it from me. Gets easier the more you do it.
Thank you.
Vultures now! This won't be easy, Aloy.
I can feel her fever even in this cold. She shouldn't have been putting weight on this leg.
She is awake. Miss Outlander. You border here, Ikri? You think I went to the Nora homelands to find a spear to drive between us? I told you. The ordeal is mine, and mine alone. I will survive!
Which would you rather keep, Mylin? Your leg, or your pride? Because I think you're gonna have to choose.
Finish it. I know what you think of me. But I vowed you'd join the White Teeth. And you will. I will go back. Alone. No! Let me do this. Please. Let her.
Mylin, I hope you can forgive me someday.
I never accepted your help. It's the Werak you should ask for forgiveness.
I didn't care about the Werak.
She'll understand. You saved her life.
You don't know the Benuk very well, Aloy. We have so many ways to express a grudge, and only one to accept an apology. I have to go my own way. I don't belong with them, who left her to die, and I don't belong with
Ikri.
I'll find a crack in this glacier, and I'll shout my grief into it. And the ice
can keep it forever.
What should I tell them? Work.
That I fell. And that she endured. Will you?
I'd have to leave something else behind. I don't know how it works, but I know how to stop it.
Thank you.
supposed to try to take you down, am I?
Has returned. I expect you have something to say about this.
I do.
Then convince me what an outlander's word is worth.
If this was a test of her endurance, I'd say she's endured more than many could bear. She put your Werak above all else. That was what kept her going, through the pain. And through the loss of a friend. She survived for you. Don't turn her away.
She is a fine teller. There is a place for my land with the white teeth.
I do not dispute it.
Outlander. So nothing of the other hunter? The one called Ikri?
She's gone. She sounded brave.
Her name will always be in my song.
You spend a weekend.
Come to test yourself? Why else would you be out here?
Forget about traveling light. Training again so soon, Akri?
Never met a hunter who wished they'd trained less. I guess I'm not in any hurry to go back to Ben-Or. Not yet.
Do you want to talk about it? What happened at the glacier?
No, I'd rather fight through it. Take it in my teeth and be left with the taste of determination. How about you, Aloy? Up for a challenge?
So you know, I told the White Teeth what you asked.
What about my Lin? Did they accept her?
They did.
As they should. She was strong. Really, I only feel pride for her. As for me, I always wanted to be a snow ghost. Free to do what I will.
What kind of challenge? A competition?
No, together. We'll use the hunting grounds, but my rules. Lovok's fine with it. We'll take in as little as possible. My sling, your bow. You draw the machines to me so I can freeze them. And then you hit them when they're brittle. We'll fight until we run out of machines or you run out of arrows. That's the challenge.
Honestly, I'm more used to fighting alone.
And I'm more used to fighting alongside another. So put your spear beside mine, why don't you?
You freeze them, I shoot them. Doesn't seem so hard.
Really? Then you'll only need half as many arrows as I'd planned to give you.
Wait.
It shows I trust your aim. Do you trust mine?
You've really got to work for a Banuk challenge, don't you?
That's the spirit. Come on, let's drop off our gear and go. Aloy, lure the machines back here and I'll freeze them. Don't worry, I don't miss.
Then I target them when they're vulnerable. Got it.
Thank you.
made that look easy. Here. You've earned this. Who taught you? Your mother? Sister?
His name was Rost.
Rost. Sounds very Nora. I can almost picture him. Stout as a tree.
And you?
Myself. I never knew my parents. There's a saying, an infant means two fewer hands to hunt with. That challenge was their gift to me.
It was a good challenge, Shikri.
Think I should settle down? Start a hunting ground of my own?
I think you could do whatever you put your mind to.
Let's not say farewell. I've had enough of that to last me a dozen winters. I hope your song finds its proper end. But it won't be easy, will it?
Is it that obvious?
Fate's a long climb on a high cliff for people like you and me.